Hi and welcome to the Financial Fox. Today is another episode about technology and we will be discussing real estate, blockchain and investment with Stefan Rind, CEO of BrickMark, who just signed an agreement for the largest ever real estate transaction paid in tokens for a value of over 130 million Swiss francs. I'm now connected to Stefan to hear more about the transaction. Hi, Stefan. How are you?
Hi, Stefania. Thank you very well. We had a great day today.
Well, that was a groundbreaking announcement.
Yes, indeed. And we were very pleased by the feedback so far, press coverage from Singapore to New York so far. It has been a long journey. We founded the company 18 months ago and we were working on the transaction for over 10 months. But in hindsight, it's really a groundbreaking deal, not only for us, but I think also for the sector, because there has been a lot of discussions about, security tokens, asset tokens, especially in relation to the real estate sector, which I think is a natural fit. But no one was really able to perform or conclude a transaction really at an institutional size.
Yeah.
We did that today with a transaction volume of over 130 million US Swiss francs. So that's really a big step, I think, not only for us, but also for the sector.
I completely agree. I think it's really a big transaction, and you are making a big point in the institutional investment space. Now, before you maybe talk a little bit more about the transaction, do you want to tell us a little bit more about your company?
Oh, sure. The company was formed about 18 months ago. Our headquarters is based in Switzerland, in Zug, in Crypto Valley. We have offices in Berlin and in Luxembourg. And actually, our Luxembourg entity did the transaction in a share deal transaction. So we acquired 80% of the shares of Bahnhofstrasse AG, a Swiss company which holds this Bahnhofstrasse 52 property. The background of myself or the team, we have a deep experience in the real estate space. So I was running a public real estate company in Germany for 9 years as a CEO. We have two advisory board members who are on the board of two public real estate companies, one in Switzerland, one in Austria. So the team combines over 100 years of experience and 15 billion assets under management in real estate. But we saw the potential of forming and designing new digital securities on the blockchain about 2 years ago, and we see the enormous potential. We saw it, and it's kind of confirmed also by the feedback we have seen so far, and that's what we worked on. And we created the BrickMark token so far, which is basically an asset-backed bond. Which is tokenized. So as a token holder, you are a bond holder and an asset-backed debt instrument. But on the same time, and this is the specialty about the DLT smart contract technology, we also enable the bond holders to perform, to have a performance right on the value appreciation of the property, 97.5%, and also on the cash flows of our portfolio. So it behaves, or legally it's a bond issue or a debt instrument, but it behaves like a share instrument. And this is a combination or a new form of capital which doesn't exist in the capital market so far. That's where we see the big innovation step.
I mean, I'm quite impressed by the size of the transaction and how did you manage to get so much interest from institutional investors, particularly when we are talking about blockchain, like the traditional institution, they are kind of concerned, let's say, they are not jumping straight away into an opportunity. So how did you handle the process?
Well, of course, a lot of of the preparation work was based on the network and long-lasting relationships we had in the industry to big players, and big credit also to RFR, the seller of the properties, who we know quite well. I mean, it's a $16 billion private investment company, and they just bought the Chrysler building in New York about 9 months ago. So big institutions, and it's about trust and about track record. And so we were able to transport the vision of our BrickMark token and also the benefits for investors as well as for the initiators of properties, and they followed our vision. And at the end of the day, you know, there's more to come. I think
exactly.
The market was waiting for a first transaction of that size, and now I think it could have some ice-breaking function for the rest of the market.
I'm sure that this will be just of a beginning of a successful journey. Now, just to wrap it up, I wanted to pick up your brain on how blockchain and new technology are going to shape the real estate industry.
Well, I think not only the real estate industry, you know, we create an asset-backed token, a security token. So my strong belief is that also in other industries where you talk about assets, and real estate, of course, is easy to understand. Everybody knows it. It's the biggest asset class in the world. And because it's the biggest asset class in the world, only 5% of all real estate, investable, investment-grade real estate, is available for public investments through shares, bonds, or fund units.
Yeah.
95% is locked in hands of private investors. So we think that that BrickMark tokens or other tokens which may follow our concept are able to unlock this value and give access to these properties and this wealth to people who never had the chance so far to invest in prime properties and top locations in the capital centers of the world. So that's the idea, and it also creates a lot of benefits for both sides. Increased liquidity, increased transparency, so it has the potential to really disrupt and improve the market overall.
Okay, thanks. So what is next for BrickMark? What you have in the pipeline?
So we have other buildings in the pipeline. We gave in the press release also a hint that it's about $1 billion in other commercial prime properties in Europe. So we're looking at two objects or properties in Berlin, right, in Berlin and in Munich right now. So we are looking to expand the portfolio, and the token will not only be backed by this one property in Bahnhofstrasse, but also by any other further acquisitions we do. And the next step, of course, is are we able to create on a listed, regulated exchange also a product for a broader market. So we are in discussion with some jurisdictions and regulators for a regulated security token offering. We haven't made a decision yet, but I think, you know, with the transaction today, things will be much easier for us in the future.
Yes, definitely. I'm really looking forward to hearing more updates from you, and I'm sure there is a really big opportunities globally, not just in Germany or in Switzerland, but, you know, if we are thinking about also emerging markets such as Africa, for example, you know, that is where I think a digital assets can really come in and also empower the population as well.
Yeah, I mean, just think about all the underbanked people.
Exactly.
I'm at the CFC conference right now in St. Moritz, and Africa is a big issue on Friday. So, yeah, there's lots of opportunities.
Okay. Thank you very much, Stefan. And I will speak to you very soon, I'm sure.
Thank you, Stefania. Take care.
Thank you. This is everything from the Financial Fox. And make sure you subscribe to our channel to keep up date with all the latest news in the technology space.